Hey guys, I'm back. In this video, I'm gonna be talking to you guys about how to create a pipeline, okay? Now, if you haven't already, be sure to like and subscribe. My channel is gonna help you guys that wanna build and grow an SMMA agency to 10, 15, or even 20K a month. And pretty much, if you click the link in the description below, you'll be able to read my story a little bit about how I grew my agency and how I had success with my clients, okay? So let's get into it. How to create a pipeline. So if you don't know what a pipeline is essentially a funnel or a sales funnel, I should say, that is in a CRM, in a sales reps or salesperson's repertoire, how they're gonna communicate and prospect and follow up with their clients over an extended period of time to onboard those clients and to get them as a client for your agency, okay? So this is gonna be good if you're an agency owner and you have a couple sales reps that work with you, or if you're actually in the front lines yourself and you're reaching out to clients making outbound calls, right? Now, the biggest reason a pipeline is very important in B2B sales, the number one thing that I teach you guys, don't look for one call closes. Okay, a lot of you are looking for one call closes and it gets you discouraged because when the person doesn't respond the way you think they should respond based on the script that you read, wherever you got it from, you believe it's the best thing and they should respond. Maybe you think that they need your services and they're saying, no, not interested, not right now. And what some of you do is you just toss that lead away, okay? That's not what you wanna do. The only time you would wanna toss the lead away if for whatever reason someone says, listen, we're a part of a do not call list, you know, don't call us, stuff like that. That's different, okay? But if someone just says, hey, not interested, not right now, you do not wanna throw that lead away, okay? So now let's get into the details. All right, a pipeline. The first thing you wanna do when you're making outbound calls is you wanna make a list, okay? Now, you can get a free CRM. You can use that, it will be helpful, or you can buy one, it's up to you, or you can use an Excel sheet, okay? Now, previously I came from CRMs, and so CRMs are very easy to manage if you like to use that. An Excel sheet, you just have to be more reminding and understanding of what you're doing, okay? You have to basically hold yourself accountable because it won't remind you when you have to call someone back. That's the only thing, okay? So for example, in a CRM, this is your pipeline, you're gonna have a couple of different tags that you tag someone, right? So let's just say you put in 100 business owners in a specific city. Let's say it's Houston, Texas, right, United States. And you wanna talk to roofers as an example. There's probably more than that, but let's just say there's 100 roofers in the whole city of Houston, Texas, right? And you now have your list. You still may not know a whole lot, but if you guys go back to the videos that I've shown you, then if you prospected them the right way, all of these people in this list, you found them advertising one way or the other, right? The second thing that you saw these business owners doing is you may have seen them, if you live in the city, you may have seen them with their trucks. You may have seen them every day. Like where I live, I see roofers with their trucks every day. Their team is out in the field, they're doing their thing. You can get an idea of how far they're willing to travel, right? You can get an idea of what they're possibly spending. And it's basically an avatar that you're creating up until you begin the process of calling them, okay? Now, step two, because you did, that first step is research, this is pipeline. Step two, you make your outbound call. Maybe you get in front of the receptionist, or maybe you get to a manager, or depending on the structure of the company, of course, or maybe you get to a general manager and or the owner of the business, right? And you do what you process, you go through your script. We're not gonna go through scripts right now, you go through your script. And they may give you a couple of different responses. Not interested, call back in a week, call back next month. It's not in our budget. Sounds good, I'm not sure, send me an email. Sounds good, let me talk to my manager, the boss, what have you, and then send everything over. These are just a couple responses, okay? So in a CRM, whatever you're using, you will basically tag each of these leads based on what they gave you, okay? And then you're gonna have what you call as your process. How often are you gonna follow up? Now, we also have another category, which is all of the businesses that you didn't yet get on the phone, okay? And so with the people you didn't get on the phone, normally what you wanna do is you wanna call two to three times a day. What I used to do is I would have a system, 10 a.m., 12 o'clock, and then 2 to 3, until I get a pulse, until I can speak with someone. Once they give me feedback, which is our responses we just had that I just read off to you, or it could be a little different depending on your system and how you want to communicate with them, then they get moved into a list. And in that list, now we have what we call our pipeline, our follow-up strategies that we're going to basically devour to them. We're going to basically, this is what we're going to do with someone who's in a not interested pile. This is what we're going to do with someone that said they need to get back to their manager, the owner of the business. This is what we're going to do with someone who said, call me back next week. When? What time? What day? Right? And so I know sometimes we always want to get this information from prospects. You know, we try to say, hey, you know, what day, what time? But guys, don't beat yourself up if they don't give you the day or time. It doesn't matter, right? Only thing that matters is getting them back on the phone the next time you call them and pitching them a seeing. And then what's gonna happen, let's say, I'll give you guys an example, and I hope this is making sense. Let's say you call a business. Guy says, not right now, call me back next week, okay? You say, what day and time? And he hangs up. You don't get him, you don't really get a response from him. You put in your calendar, spoke to whoever, maybe didn't get their name, said call back in a week. Okay, here's Monday morning. Boom, pick up the phone. This is your first calls, always go to first follow-ups. Why? You want to catch them early unless they give you a time. Okay? Your first call goes to that person or those particular people. You call, let's just say it's the same thing. Okay? Doesn't give you an opportunity, same thing, boom, hangs up, says call me back next time. Hangs up. No problem. Now, if it's Monday, I probably will put him to Wednesday or Friday, every 2 days, right? But if it's like a Friday, I'm gonna call him back next Monday, top of the morning. I'm gonna keep doing that until I get him to basically give me a minute, and then maybe the next minute he says, listen, bud, I know you keep calling me, you know, I don't have time. Maybe he might even say this time, I'm not interested. Okay, now he's in the not interested pile. Okay, every 2 weeks, he's getting a call. If you got his email, you might now send out an email. So some of you might say, Mike, This might be a little too much. Maybe you're calling a guy too much. Listen to me. No, there is no such thing as too much. Okay, and I hope you guys understand it. When I did this in my previous endeavor, I would call businesses until they got, it would be so intense sometimes people would say, guy, you call in this office 6-7 times a day. What is it that you need? And then that's, okay, great, now I can, listen, I need 2 minutes to tell you about what I have. 2 minutes, 60 seconds, 30 seconds, whatever it is. See, there's a couple of different things that I haven't shown you guys yet, okay? And in many cases, depending on how you're gonna structure your agency, it's gonna be duplication, okay? It's made for the new people, right? The people that come in, they're doing sales calls for you. But if you're making sales calls, that's okay too, because you can incorporate these same strategies, learn it, and then you can teach it to your team as well, right? But that's the strategy of pipeline, making the calls. If you call someone, I'm just gonna give you guys the numbers, a certain amount of times, you're leaving messages, you're sending emails. Now, obviously not to the point of where you're annoying someone to death. You know, I don't call, if I'm getting the business owner right on the phone, I'm not calling them 6 times a day, 7 times a day. It's not needed. I'm calling B2B and maybe I'm getting into this sales department or that sales department. If I can't get the person on the phone, then I may do that because I'm still getting filtered around the business, right? And I need to get that person's voicemail. I need to get that person on the phone. I need to send that person an email. I might even say that to another person, say, Steve, listen, every time I call your office, I always get you. Listen, I know who I need to speak to. I know they might be avoiding, but I promise you, I have something that you guys have never heard of before. You have to hear what I have, right? And then Steve is going to be like, listen, he's not available right now. She's not available right now. I say, Steve, no problem. I'm going to be back with you tomorrow, 10 a.m. I've got Steve's ear. Steve knows who I am, what I do, and he knows why I'm calling. Steve gets it. Steve is also in sales. Steve's like, all right, no problem. I'm not pissing him off. I'm not saying nasty things. I'm building my relationship with them. That's where it starts in some phone calls and some businesses. Or heck, maybe you get the owner on the phone, right? And the owner is just, he's just joshing with you. He's just talking, right? He's not really listening. He's like, yeah, I know you always call. I know this, I know that. I'm not ready yet. And you're building rapport. Say, hey, no problem. When you're ready, listen, I promise I have something that you guys would love to have for your business. This will definitely help you guys get more sales. All I want is 2 minutes to tell you about my program, my product, my service, right? And some of you guys might say, that sounds a little needy. That sounds like you're not, you know, in control of the call. Guys, that's not what making outbound calls is about. You probably have seen movies and seen things where you think that a cold call is about this one and done, lights out, you lit a guy on fire, so to speak, call. That's not what it is. It kind of, you know, messed you guys up with that thinking. The cold call is just to make the initial contact, okay? The follow-up is where the sale is, because somebody could duck you once, somebody can duck you twice, somebody can duck you 50 times, right? But eventually, if they are advertising and marketing and they believe in marketing, they will give you an opportunity to speak to you. That's from my opinion. From, I would say, I would say about 70 to 80% of the time, you will almost get everybody on the phone. I think the longest that I went without signing up a prospect was 2.5 years. The longest. And I still signed up other prospects. But I never stopped following up. And you want to incorporate this into your pipeline. You never want to stop following up. And when you have a CRM, it becomes a lot more manageable and easy, because you can automate sending up emails and even texts if, you know, you might want to. I would, depending on the system, emails, you know, you can send an email as often as you like. Text, if you guys wanted to incorporate it, I probably do maybe once a month. Hey, especially around, or like near the end of the month, I probably would, if you wanted to do it and you know, you had their number, say, hey, I know we spoke, I know we're going into a new month, I wanted to see if we had an opportunity to speak about what we're doing, because it's very successful for, you know, ABC niche, right? And that's prospecting. Now, there's a recipe to prospecting. I've given you guys a lot of big nuggets, but there's a recipe. Okay, the blueprint to prospecting is, the number one thing you don't want to do is you don't want to be lazy in prospecting. Prospecting is where all the money is at. It's not in these one call closes that a lot of people are looking for. Yeah, you can have a good call, but you might have to follow up once, twice, or three times, because the person may get busy, may not be the right time, it may not be out of their budget, and obviously those things may be objections that you say, oh, that's not real, that's a smokescreen. Sometimes it may be out of their budget, right? So you don't want to be rude or condescending. You just want to go with it, not a problem. Always have a good PMA, positive mental attitude. Always exude positivity to your prospects. Why? Because positivity is infectious. If a guy is not having the best week or the best month, and here you come, you know, positive, excited, happy, you know you have something that can help him, he's gonna say, man, what do you have? I've seen it. I've seen it with top salespeople. They're getting calls, GMs and owners. And eventually they turn and say, man, I've yelled at this guy, I've told this guy to jump off a cliff, and he still doesn't stop. What do you have? I've seen it all, guys, so trust me. If you called a business once and they said, not interested, and you said, oh, I've called everybody in my local city, nobody is interested. Listen to me, keep calling your prospects, okay? Or whatever your niche is, right? Keep calling them, send them the emails, the follow-up, right? And you're gonna build out a system that becomes workable. Now, if you guys really wanna get granular with your system, what you can do is click the link in the description below. You can book a strategy call with me, or maybe some of you need a coach, right? All of these things I've already built out. All of these things I know work. And all of these things are what you call duplicatable. So you don't need to be the hero on the phone, no. All you have to do is say the pitch. Once you get the pitch over, you have a couple objection rebuttals. Once you get that done, this person is gonna go into a folder. Where's it gonna be? Not interested, interested, call me back, you know, and all the others. That's it. Once all of that is done, guess what? You're gonna start bringing in clients consistently. It's the pipeline that feeds your business. It's not the one-time intro, it's the pipeline that feeds your business. All of the people you spoke to in the last month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, a year, if you're doing this the right way, in a year, you'll probably speak to over 500 businesses that fit your pipeline. And the people that, you know, obviously, you know, X'd off, they said, don't ever call back, this is not what we do, take me off your list, that's a different cat. You're gonna have more of those. But if you put in 500 real recipe people that believe in marketing, spending money in marketing, they're just not a client of yours yet, you will be amazed at how many businesses you can sign up in a year. Whether you think you're the best thing on the phone or the worst thing, it doesn't matter. When you like cold calling or you don't, you will still sign up clients. You do not need to be the best on the phone. You just need to be what? Consistent. So guys, listen, if this video has been helpful, definitely hit the like button, share, subscribe, leave a comment or two. I'll definitely get back to the comments, and I'll see you guys next time.